Hello guys, what's up? Welcome to preptab. This is a quick revision video lecture on chemical kinetics. As many of you might be appearing for JEE mains or NEET in the coming year, so I hope this video helps you revise the whole concept very quickly. I'll also share some tricks which will help you solve the question easily. In this chapter we will be I'll cover rate law, rate of the reaction, integrated rate law and dependence of rate constant on temperature. So we will be covering these concepts related to this chapter. I have chosen some previous year questions so that our preparation is in line with what the exam demands. So this is me, Himanshu. I am a graduate from IIT Kharagpur. So let's begin. Our first question is, we have a reaction 2A plus B gives C. Initial rate of reaction is given to us along with concentration of A and concentration of B. We have to find out rate law of the reaction. Rate law can be written as rate of the reaction is equal to K concentration of reactant A to the power M and reactant B to the power N. M and N, they are order with respect to A and order with respect to B, and K is rate constant which is dependent on temperature. So this is temperature dependent. Okay, so since in this question we are not changing temperature, temperature remains constant, so I can say that rate is proportional to concentration of A to the power M and concentration of B to the power N. Now coming back to the question, I'll be using this equation, rate is proportional to A to the power M and B to the power N, to solve this question. So from our first set of data, I can say that concentration of A has been doubled, concentration of B is constant, and with respect to that the initial rate has been doubled, right? So I can say that if we are doubling the concentration of A, our rate is getting doubled. That means M will be 1, M should be 1. So our rate law becomes A to the power 1 and B to the power N. From here you can say that option C or D should be the correct option. Okay, choosing from next set of data, I can say that our concentration of A has been doubled, B has been doubled, and with respect to that rate of the reaction has been multiplied by 8, has become 8 times. So this has become 8, this has been doubled, and this has also been doubled. So on solving this, I am going to get that 4 is equal to 2 to the power n. So I can say that n should be 2. So our rate law becomes R equals to K A to the power 1 B to the power 2. That means option D is our correct option. So this is the easiest question from this chapter that you can get. Coming on to our next question, we have a plot of concentration of reactant versus time, and we have to identify for which order of reaction these plots are. Suppose I have a reaction, let's say A gives B, right? And at t equals to 0, the concentration was A naught, and at time t, concentration is AT. For zero order reaction, I can write rate that is equal to minus dA by dt. This is known as rate of disappearance of A. That is equal to K times concentration of A, since order is 0, so to the power 0. So this becomes K. Similarly, for first order, I can write rate equals to minus dA by dt equal to K into concentration of A to the power 1, right? So this is the relation between rate of reaction and concentration of reactant for zero order and first order reaction. Now if we integrate these rate laws, we will get integrated rate loss. So for zero order, you will get AT equals to A naught minus KT. Let's name it equation 1. And for first order, you will get ln AT equals to ln A naught minus KT. So this is equation 2. So from equation 1, you can say that if we have concentration of the reactant on y-axis and time on x-axis, I'll get a straight line equation, right? This is my y, this is my x. I'll get a straight line equation with slope minus k. That means value of slope will give you rate constant. So this is minus k. So that means since we have a linear graph for concentration of reactant with time, so this is for zero order reaction. And you can see the options that only option C contains zero order for second reaction. For first graph, you can compare ln AT versus T. This is also a straight line graph between ln AT and T with a negative slope. That means concentration of A, ln of concentration of A will decrease with time, right? And the slope is minus K. Okay. Now this equation, equation 2 can also be written as AT equals to A naught e to the power minus KT. So this equation tells that our concentration of reactant for first order decreases exponentially with time. So it will be an exponential decrease of concentration. Now, one more thing that I would like to add to this question is that half-life. Half-life is the time at which concentration of reactant has become half. So this is our half-life. 50% of the reaction is complete up till half-life. So if we calculate half-life for zero order reaction, we get T half equals to A naught by 2k, right? And 100% completion will take A naught by k. At 100% completion, concentration of AT will be zero. So this will be zero. So you get A naught by k, which is, as you can see, it is twice of T half. For first order, our T half is ln 2 by k. You can substitute the values AT as A naught by 2 and you will get ln 2 by k. Value of ln 2 is 0.693. Remember this. So T half is ln 2 by k, independent of concentration. 100% completion. So at 100% completion, AT should be 0, but the value of ln 0 is not defined. So that means first order reactions are never 100% complete. Okay. 75% completion, that means 3/4 of the reaction has been completed and the concentration of reactant at this time will be A naught by 4. So at this point, the time will be twice of T half. That means 2 ln 2 by k. For 87.5% completion, it will take 3 times of T half. These are the graphs for zero order and first order reaction. You can see if we plot a graph of rate of reaction versus concentration. For zero order, we have already seen that our rate of reaction is independent of concentration. It depends only on K. So if we increase the concentration of reactant, our rate of reaction will not change. It will remain constant. And for first order, if we increase the concentration, it will increase linearly because there is a linear relation between rate of the reaction and concentration of reactant. Plot of concentration versus time, that means AT versus time. For zero order, we have already seen it will decrease linearly. And for first order, decrease will be exponential, e to the power minus KT. So it will decrease exponentially. Okay, so our correct answer is option C. Moving on to our next question, we have decomposition of X exhibits at a rate constant of this. So rate constant K has been given to us 0.05 mole per liter minute. Suppose I have a reaction, let's say X is decomposing to Y. at t equal to 0, we are given 5 molar concentration, and we have to find out the time in which it will become 2.5 molar. K is given to us, we have to find out time. One more thing is required to solve this question, that is the order of this reaction, right? Because then only you will be able to apply the integrated rate law for that particular order. Now, that has not been given to us in this question. But please note that order of the reaction can also be found out from the unit of K, right? What is K? You can write rate law equals to K times concentration of reactant to the power order. K becomes R by A to the power N. Unit of R, rate of the reaction is change in concentration with time. That means unit of R will be mole per liter per time. And unit of concentration, that is mole per liter, right? So using this, you can say that if the reaction is zero order, K becomes R. Unit of R is mole per liter time. And if it is first order, K becomes R by concentration. So unit becomes 1 by time. So by looking at the unit of K, you can tell what is the order of that reaction. For this question, I can say that the reaction is zero order. So please remember these units, because most of the time in many questions you won't be given order directly, but that has to be found by looking at the unit of K. Okay guys, so since now I know that it is a zero order reaction, integrated rate law for zero order is AT equals to A naught minus KT. So on solving this, you will get 2.5 equals to 5 minus 0.05 T. And you can solve this, you will get T equals to 50 minutes. So A is our correct option. Now I'll share a small trick to solve this question very quickly. See, you can see that the concentration of X is changing from 5 to 2.5. That means it is becoming 50%. So basically you are being asked what is the half-life of this reaction, T half, right? And we have already discussed that for zero order reaction, T half is A naught by 2k. We know what A naught is, we know what K is, so you can simply put in the values that A naught is 5, 2 by K 0.05, you will get 50 minutes. Okay, coming on to our next question, we have decomposition of H2O2. So I'll just write down the equation. H2O2 gives H2O plus half O2. So we are given that in 50 minutes, the concentration of H2O2 decreases from 0.5 to 0.125. So that means at T equals to 0, we had 0.5 molar. And in 50 minutes, it becomes 0.125 molar. When the concentration of H2O2 reaches 0.05 molar, we have to find out the rate of formation of O2. Okay. At 0.05 molar, we have to find out the rate of formation of O2. Rate of formation of O2 is dO2 by dt. The rate of the reaction can be related to rate of disappearance of H2O2, or rate of appearance to H2O, or rate of appearance of O2, as rate of the reaction is dH2O2 by dt. But since this is the reactant, its concentration is decreasing, so I have to put a negative sign over here. dH2O by dt, I'll put a positive sign because the concentration is increasing with time. And for O2, you can see in the reaction only half mole of O2 is being formed. So I have to divide it by half. This gives dO2 by dt. Now this is what has been asked in the question. Also, rate of the reaction can be related to concentration of H2O2, that is our reactant, as K times concentration of H2O2. When the concentration of H2O2 is 0.05, that is the time when we have to find out the rate of formation of O2. So that means at 0.05 concentration, rate of the reaction will be K 0.05, and it will be equal to twice of DO2 by DT. I'm putting this as equation 1. Okay, so now the only thing that I have to do is I have to find out the value of K so that I can calculate DO2 by DT, right? And to calculate the value of K, we have been given this data. So you can, since it is a first order reaction, you can simply use ln AT by A naught, that is equal to minus KT, and this gives ln 0.5 by 0.125, that is equal to K into 50. On solving this, you will get ln 4, that is equal to K 50. So K is 2 ln 2 by 50. Now you can substitute this value in equation 1. There is a trick to solve this question. You can see that the concentration of H2O2 is decreasing from 0.5 to 0.125 molar in 50 minutes. Now half of 0.5 is 0.25 and half of 0.25 is 0.125. That means 75% of the reaction has been completed, right? So basically this 50 is T75%. And we know the formula, we have already discussed it, that T75% is twice of T half. And what is T half? It is ln 2 by K. So from here you can directly get the value of K, that is 2 ln 2 by 50. Now we can put this value in our equation 1. So we'll get DO2 by DT equal to 1 by 2 into 2 ln 2 by 50 into 0.05. So on solving this, you will get 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 4, which is our option A. So option A is the correct answer. Okay, coming to our next question. For the reaction of H2 and I2 at 327 degrees Celsius, that is 600 Kelvin, rate constant is 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 4, and at 800 Kelvin, rate constant is 1. So this is given to us. I've already mentioned that our rate constant is dependent on temperature, right? So K is dependent on temperature. That is K equals to A e to the power minus E A by RT, where A is Arrhenius constant. It depends on the collision of reactant molecules and the orientation in which they are colliding. Okay, EA is the activation energy, I'll come to that, and T is the temperature, R is gas constant, it has been given to us. So this is the Arrhenius equation, let's say this is equation 1. If I take ln on both sides, I'll get ln K equals to ln A minus EA by RT. So this is our equation 2, right? And this equation can be converted to one more equation, that is ln K1 by K2 equals to minus EA by R, 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. This is our equation 3. See, I have already told you that K, rate constant, is dependent on temperature. Okay, so let's say at temperature T1, rate is K1. Rate constant is K1, and at temperature T2, rate constant is K2. So there is a relation between T1, T2 and K1, K2, that is ln K1 by K2 equals to minus EA by R, 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. So to solve this question, I'll be using equation 3. Just substitute the values, ln 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 4 by 1, that is equal to minus EA by 8.314. 1 by 600 minus 1 by 800. And on solving this, you will get EA equal to 164.9 approximately kilojoule. In kilojoule, I am telling. Okay, so A is our closest answer. Say I have a reaction, let's say reactant gives intermediate and which is getting converted to product. For this reaction, I can draw an energy diagram between energy and reaction progress. Reactants will get converted to an intermediate and the intermediate will get converted to product. This is the energy barrier. Since this is a two-step reaction, I have two barriers, two energy barriers. So reactant molecules will have to cross this energy barrier to get converted to intermediate. And further, intermediate will have to cross this energy barrier to get converted to product. First thing that is to note over here is, this is the energy of reactant and this is the energy of products. Delta H reaction, that means enthalpy of a reaction, of this reaction, is written as summation of enthalpy of product minus summation of enthalpy of reactant. And from here you can say that enthalpy of product is less than enthalpy of reactant. So this will be negative, since enthalpy of product is less than enthalpy of reactant. So this comes out to be negative, means that energy is getting out of the reaction. That means this reaction is exothermic in nature. Okay, this is the first thing that we have to note. Second thing, activation energy. Activation energy is the additional energy which these reactant molecules require to cross this energy barrier. And they already possess this energy, right? Now they need to get to this point. So they require this much additional energy to cross this energy barrier. This extra amount of energy that is required is known as activation energy, which we are calling as EA. Again, now they have converted to intermediate. Now, to get converted from intermediate to product, they require this much amount of extra energy. This is known as activation energy for step 2. Let's call it for step 1. Okay. As you can see from the graph, that reactant molecules require more activation energy to get converted to intermediate as compared to EA2. So I can say that EA1 is more than EA2. More energy is required for reactant molecules to get converted to intermediate than for intermediate to product. So this means that our first reaction will be slow. Conversion of reactant to intermediate will be slow as compared to intermediate to product. So this is slow. Well, this is fast. Since this is the slowest step in the reaction, this step will be known as rate determining step, RDS. This is the slowest step. That means if K1 is the rate constant for first reaction and K2 was the rate constant for second reaction, K1 will be less than K2, because our first reaction is slow. So the value of rate constant will be less for this step. Coming on to equation 2, I can write ln K equals to ln A minus EA by R 1 by T. A graph between ln K versus 1 by T can be asked, which is a straight line with negative slope. This ln K versus 1 by T, and the slope is minus EA by R. So this is a negative slope. The value of slope is minus EA by R, and our y-intercept is ln A. So activation energy can also be calculated from this graph if it is given in the question, ln K versus 1 by T. I'll be sharing more videos in the coming days, which will be helpful for your preparation. Please do like, share or subscribe if you like the video. Thank you for watching.